Alright, so we're just positioned on the runway here, runway 22 in Las Cruces. We're gonna fly straight out. Elevation here is 4,700.
Kilo Lima Romeo, Uniform Traffic Cessna November 2727 Foxtrot is taxiing to runway 22.
So we're going to taxi straight, well, we're going to take off straight out here. And then make a left turn. And really, we're not going to be using any navigation. I'm just going to fly until I see a spot in I-10 that I had looked at on the sectional map. And then we're just going to fly east from there. So we're going to take off here. And then we'll be heading to Del City, which I actually had intended going a little bit further, but the flights get to be so long that I decided to go ahead and go to Del City. So this is about an hour long flight. I would appreciate you guys if you would like and subscribe to the channel. It does really help. And just let me know in the comments below if you want me to make these videos shorter. I will. Again, this is flying across the country. We started in San Diego. The first couple of flights were about a little over an hour, so they're pretty long flights overall. But just leave me a comment below, and then I'll come up with a plan to make it as user-friendly as possible. I mean, this is, again, all the way across the country from San Diego to Jacksonville, Florida. But I would, again, appreciate if you like and subscribe, so that does help. And it helps push the videos, you know, so I can continue to make more. Alright, so we're airborne now. We're going to climb to 1,000 AGL. As you can see, it's pretty bumpy. And taking a look at the desert is really interesting. So I think that actually, we're just crossing over as I-10. And we're going to swing all the way back around to the east. The way that I had planned it was there was really no great navigation. I mean, there's a way to do triangulation, all this stuff, but I'm not going to do that. It was just simple enough just to do some basic VFR, look for some landmarks, and go from there. So I went ahead and I planned my route to try and avoid some restricted areas and to stay clear of some Class Charlie airspace. So there's a little gap we can fly through that'll get us headed directly east. And then I'll fly toward the Salt Flats VOR, even though I'm not going to pick up the Salt Flats VOR. I'm just going to fly towards it so I know I'm headed in the right general direction, but again, you really just can't mess this up. It's simple navigation and, you know, just follow the compass, really. kind of hazy. Otherwise, it's clear. It's VFR condition, but it's still somewhat hazy. We're climbing out 80. I-10 there. So I'm just going to follow this along. And there should be a spot here to cross over. It's just a narrow gap on the sectional. Some sort of aquifer there. It's hard to see it on the sectional though, but it looks like it's definitely there. And we're just going to fly parallel to I-10 for the moment. Looking out for aircraft. This haze really makes me uncomfortable. It's VFR, but you still can't see that far. amazing. Looks like we're pretty well dialed in here. Our cruise altitude. Good airspeed going. Everything's in the green, so we're doing pretty good. Just waiting for this haze. So we're gonna make our turn here. We're turning into the haze. Trying to see where I'm at on the map, not using the GPS, so to speak, but in other words, I'm not flying by the RNAV. Or the GPS for that matter. So
Albuquerque Center, Cessna November 2727 Foxtrot is type Cessna Skyhawk 14 miles southeast of Kilo Lima Romeo Uniform. Request flight following.
Cessna November 2727 Foxtrot Albuquerque Center. Squawk 2755.
Squawk 2755 Cessna 27 Foxtrot.
Cessna 27 Foxtrot radar contact 15 miles north of November Mike 057,800 feet. Altimeter 29.70.
Copy Cessna 27 Foxtrot.
I probably wouldn't even pick up flight following, but if it went for this haze, it makes me uncomfortable doing that. I remember a time where I was actually in my primary flight training, and I took off, and it was so darn hazy, I just turned right around and came back. Really, it was uncomfortable. This actually worked out perfectly. This is the exact spot that I want to cross over because the mountains are low at this spot. I mean, if you have an engine out or something like that, that makes it easy. You're already in a flat spot. You don't have to worry about crashing into a mountain.
Cessna 27 Foxtrot, contact El Paso approach on 119.15.
Cessna 27 Foxtrot. El Paso approach, Cessna November 2727 Foxtrot, 8,000 feet.
Cessna November 2727 Foxtrot.
I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to just start making these much shorter. So I'll just, and we'll just do it in 100 steps if necessary, from airport to airport. It just takes too long to fly for an hour over the desert, for example, or over even forests. I mean, there's nothing really that much to see. So it's going to be a lot better for me to go from airport to airport, make it a 20-minute video, make it easier for everybody to watch. So I think that's what I'm going to do. And just we'll have 50 parts of a cross-country flight across the country. That's the only thing I really think of. This is just way too long. But you make it more interesting, ultimately, because we're going from airport to airport rather than just flying along. I mean, once you set the autopilot, then there's not much to do, really. Dial up the Salt Flats VOR. I don't see it in this list. I don't know why it's not on the list. Maybe we're just too far away. So it's 69 miles away to Salt Flats. So we're just going to cruise along here. There's really not much to say other than we're flying over the desert. And it's hazy. So we'll pick it up when we get ready to land. We get a little bit closer to Del City. But it's all desert from here. Super boring, nothing to see. We'll let the plane run here and we'll pick it up in just a few minutes when we get to landing.
165 for Cessna 27 Foxtrot. Albuquerque Center, Cessna November 2727 Foxtrot, 8,000 feet.
Cessna November 2727 Foxtrot, Albuquerque Center, continue as planned. Altimeter 29.75.
Thank you.
center on 135.875.
Cessna 27 Foxtrot. Albuquerque Center, Cessna November 2727 Foxtrot, 8,000 feet.
Cessna November 2727 Foxtrot, Albuquerque Center, continue as planned. Altimeter 29.69.
Center, Cessna 27 Foxtrot. Cancel flight following.
Cessna 27 Foxtrot, Albuquerque Center. Cancellation received. Squawk 1200. Frequency change approved.
Traffic Cessna November 2727 Foxtrot 6 miles southwest 8,000 feet inbound to land runway 26. Traffic Cessna November 2727 Foxtrot 4 miles southwest 7,900 feet inbound to land runway 26.
Yeah, so we're almost there. And the airport's really, it's right in front of me the most part, but I'm just a little too high, so what I'm going to do is just take a look here. Yep, so there's the runway. No, that's not the runway. So what I'll do is I'll just do a 360 here, and that'll set me up for a better approach to the runway. I really like the scenery. It's just so amazing. So realistic. I mean, of course it's realistic. It's modeled after the map, but it's so immersive. I mean, you literally are simulating the fact that you're actually in this particular longitude and latitude. You're actually in this part of the country, part of the world, whatever. There is our runway right there. So we're still a little high. But that's okay. So really just going to be a kind of a high, long downwind. Uncontrolled airport.
2 Echo 5 traffic, Cessna November 2727 Foxtrot is on downwind runway 26.
Yeah, I'm the only airplane for 1,000 miles apparently.
Traffic Cessna November 2727 Foxtrot is on base runway 26.
Autopilot, get control of this bird. A lot of farming out here. I wonder what they farm out here. It's like the middle of the desert. So,
5 traffic, Cessna November 2727 Foxtrot is on final runway 26 to land.
Oh. Pretty narrow runway here. We got the runway made, though, so we're going to drop all the flaps here. Got a nice smooth ascent going, 60 knots.
2 Echo 5 traffic, Cessna November 2727 Foxtrot is on final runway 26 to land.
Pretty good. Not too worried about the height here. Okay, gust of wind there. I wasn't sure about the wind, but I just chose this runway. It made sense. And right down the center line. Boom. I do appreciate appreciate you sticking with me on the video. I'm going to get another one going here real soon. The next leg. I'm going to make them shorter, though. An hour is just too long. And I don't expect you to watch a whole hour of my flight across the country. So I'm just going to do them in pieces. Again, would appreciate it if you subscribe to the channel and like the video. And we'll do another one here real soon. Take care.